Hi, I'm Kathie Jurek, content lead at Aleo, and this is Zero to Zero Knowledge, a short series about the importance of privacy on the blockchain and how Aleo is making it a reality with zero knowledge technology. Privacy on the blockchain, it sounds like an oxymoron that goes against Web3's commitment to transparency. However, there are some things we just don't want to share with the world. Balance of our retirement accounts, our medical records, our school transcripts, just to name a few. But zero-knowledge proofs can reshape how we share personal information, giving people more control and developers the power to build applications that are private by default. First, you might be wondering, what is a zero-knowledge proof? To put it simply, it's a way of proving you know something without revealing the information itself. For example, you could confirm that your credit score is over 700 points without needing to reveal the exact score. Lots of people are working on integrating zero-knowledge into their products, which has resulted in a few different approaches. The zero-knowledge solutions that exist today fall into two distinct buckets. Those built on top of Ethereum, known as zero-knowledge Ethereum virtual machines, or zkEVMs, and custom-built options called zero-knowledge virtual machines, also known as zkVMs. Before we get into the differences, let's review how we got here and why privacy has become so essential for developers to consider when building applications for Web3. Each new crypto evolution that's come along builds upon the ones that came before it. First, Bitcoin prioritized security. Ethereum then added programmability with smart contracts. However, its computation-intensive approach led to high gas fees and slow transactions. Rollups emerged to improve scalability, but they're only as private as the layer one they're built on. And as more users looked for control over their data, privacy became table stakes for any application looking to scale. Now, let's go back to the two zero-knowledge approaches I mentioned earlier, zkEVMs and zkVMs. They both promise to revolutionize how we transact, interact, and develop applications on the blockchain. So what sets them apart? zkEVMs integrate with Ethereum's ecosystem, inheriting both its strengths and its limitations. Optimized for compatibility with the Ethereum blockchain, they benefit from Ethereum's vast user base and its ease of use for developers. But here's the challenge. Ethereum was built to be completely public and transparent, and that transparency, it comes at a cost. Every transaction is available for the world to see, which is fine for some applications and a privacy nightmare for others. And the nature of its shared infrastructure makes integrating zero-knowledge proofs and other privacy features more challenging. zkVMs, on the other hand, are built from the ground up with a zk-first mentality. They optimize their environment to make integrating zero-knowledge proofs into on-chain transactions not only less expensive, but also more efficient and user-friendly. With the right zkVM, every application can seamlessly harness the power of zero-knowledge proofs, effortlessly enhancing privacy, security, and scalability without the need for add-on solutions. Aleo falls into the zkVM camp with one major difference. We've created a privacy-focused layer one blockchain that integrates ZK into every layer of our tech stack. This ensures end users don't need to opt into privacy because the Aleo network is private by default. And it puts programmable privacy into the hands of developers, allowing them to control what inputs, if any, are public. Privacy and security will continue to be an issue as more users prioritize their privacy online. With Aleo, developers now have a platform option without compromises, making it easy to create amazing applications, build in privacy, and give end users complete control over their data. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like to get to know Aleo more, check out aleo.org or the links in the description. Also, let us know in the comments what you'd like us to talk about next. Bye!